Hey, what's happening, guys? YG here, back from Let's Play Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door. So right now we're just making our way back from Poshley Heights on the XX Express. Luckily we don't have to go back those 3 days, god. Talk about backtracking, jeez. And I just noticed those stars go down from like 1s to 5s, I don't know. If you see right there it's 2, then it goes to like... Oh wait, never mind. Mario, that sounds like an email from Princess Peach. Yeah, we gotta read that. This is like the last email, so I might as well hear this whole song. Ah, great little tune right there. Mario, I know where I'm being held. I'm on the moon, yes, the moon that floats up in space. And I've learned something even more horrifying. In order to resurrect the monster spirit, they need my... Aw, talk about a cliffhanger, jeez. The moon? That's totally nuts! Princess Peach is on the moon? I mean, that actually sounds pretty cool, but why is her email cut off? That was when she was getting captured. Oh my gosh, do you think something happened to her? Do you? Yeah, one would assume that something happened to her, but like I was saying, look at the stars. It goes from 2 to 3, I don't know. I thought that was pretty neat, I just noticed that now. Oh, pfft, it's Luigi. Aw, man, paradox! Actually, no, I'm wearing Waluigi. I'm always better than you. No, I'm not hearing about your stupid stories. And what the hell is this thing supposed to be? It's like an onion, I think? Screamy. Ah, whatever, you're not important. I only talk to protagonists. Alright, so let's make our way to the Thousand Year Door, because then we can learn the next location of the next crystal star, which we basically already can assume where it is. If you put two and two together. So let's just make our way to the right. And we're underground. We're in the underground city. Ugh. So what we can do now is with Bobber. I don't think I did it yet. Yeah, you can break down this barrier with Bobber. I'm surprised I didn't do this yet. And there we go, a shortcut. Aw, poor Bobbery. Now let's put back Goombella. She's pretty cool. Give her some screen time. And, I might as well say this now, I'm actually using a different recording method right now, because as you may not know, I just got my new laptop. It actually has a built-in sound recorder that I don't even need a headset for, so I thought that was pretty cool, and I'm actually trying that out for this episode, so... If you guys like it, just post in the comments, I'd love to hear your feedback. Yeah, so either this or my old headset. Alright? Post your comments. Now we're at the Thousand Year Door, and for the second to last time, let's go on the pedestal. Man, that star looks so similar to the one we got in freaking Blitzville, I don't know. They kind of got really uncreative, or not as creative with the couple of the crystal stars, I don't know. They could have gone with the rainbow, but I don't know, they just kind of went with different shades of colors. Now let's raise that treasure map high! Let it float above our heads, and Mario's still surprised at that actually happening. It's only the sixth time and all. Now let's see, where are you? We've pretty much gone every place on the map. Up! It's on the moon! Who would have thunk it? Yes, the X-Nauts were talking about them having one crystal star. And wow, that's actually a pretty cool, the most cool-looking one out of all the crystal stars, in my opinion. And yes, the next location has been confirmed. To the moon! Ah, okay, that is like a total typo or something. Do you see that, Mario? The last crystal star. It can't be there. Au contraire, Goombella. This is a Mario game. We can defy physics and the laws of nature and time. If what this map indicates, the location of the final crystal star is... The moon. The moon? Princess Peach is there too? This just seems wrong on, like, so many levels. The problem here is, how does one get to the moon? Quite a conundrum. Give me a moment to look into this. Excuse me, please. This shouldn't take long. I don't know, there's only a couple of options to get to the moon. A rocket, A cannon? I don't know. What else can you look up? Looking into this maybe take a little bit of a time. So come back in a bit, alright? Alright, what's in this? Probably the smorg. Yeah, always the boss battles are always in his little trash bin, so nothing too surprising. And we got an email, but it's not important. Oh, we might as well stop at the Merlin's and cash out some of our our shine sprites. About to say star pieces. And let's see, we'll upgrade Bobbery. And we have one more upgrade we can do, so let's actually figure this out. Let's see. Might do Gumbella instead of Koops, because, I don't know, Koops is okay, but if you have Bobbery, basically, or you have Yoshi, you can take out all the enemies as well, so it makes them less special, but whatever. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Gumbella, because I believe that a new ability she gets is Rally Wing, and that actually makes us able to attack twice in one turn, so that can be a very good move to have. And I might be using Gumbella a lot more, because I found out she's actually a pretty good party member, with her multi-bonk and all. There we go, we upgraded our two party members for the time being. And let's see their new moves. Yeah, Gumbella, Rally Wink. Yeah, Wink at Mario, give him the courage for an extra attack. Very good one, along with our multi-bonk. And Bobbery learned the Bombast, attack all enemies with a massive blast, just like, Bombette did in the last game. And he has 40 HP, wow. Jeez. Talk about a powerhouse. And even Gumbella has the same HP as us, and Bobbery has 10 more than us, wow. Oh, and another thing we could actually do is, you know this treasure chest we've been passing throughout the whole entire game? Well, we can finally get it! By doing that spring jump we just learned, and there we go! It knocks it down. I think this is the last treasure chest we'll find. And it beholds the Ultra Hammer! I wonder if we'll be using that in the next chapter. We'll see. Hi, it's me again, Toadette. Nice to see you again. Way to find the Ultra Hammer. Now your hammer will be even more powerful. And you can also use a new hammer technique. Let's practice it right away. It's just like the Super Hammer, but so no prob. Hold down B and rotate the control stick. I know this move already. Silly. I don't know why they're explaining this again. We've already done this, so I don't know. Maybe it's more powerful? I have no idea. Yeah, way to go, you got it! Wanna try again? No, I got it. Alright, you've mastered the Ultra Hammer. It was just like the last one, I don't understand. Ah, now we can take out stone blocks. Ah, I see. And you can use the Ultra Hammer in battle too. Aw, she got a sad face, what's wrong? This is kind of sad. This is the last time I'll get to see you, Mario. Aw. Bye, Toadette. Definitely save Princess Peach, okay? And be careful on your quest, okay? Aww. Poor Toadette. Yeah, I don't know. Toadette to me was like Nintendo's way of trying to get like another Toad character in. But it kind of failed in trying to get Toadette as an established Mario character, because she only appeared in a handful of games and then she honestly just faded away. Okay, so now we have this new Ultra Hammer. So we actually have the, as you can see here, we have the Ultra Boots, and now we have the Ultra Hammer, so we're already done with all our upgrades right there. I think that's been a long enough time for Frankly to come up with a way for us to get to the moon, so let's just make our way back to him and see if he's ready. If he's not, I'll be really surprised. Alright, Frankly, are you ready? You found us a way? Yeah, you did. Oh, there we go. Ah, excellent timing! I finally have it, Mario! I found a way to get us to the moon. You must go to Far Outpost, and you must use the cannon there, and it will blast you. Hello? We're using a cannon to get to the moon? Isn't that, like, kind of dangerous? Yeah, I don't know. Isn't a cannon, like, an untraditional way to get to the moon? Why not a rocket? I don't know. Have they never gone to space before? Jeez. Terrible space program. I know how it sounds, really. To be honest, I'm not entirely sure of all the details. Accounts from Far Outpost speak of a device that can launch anything, anywhere. Even the moon. Great, sounds super real-y, so where is this Far Outpost anyway? I believe there's a pipe to Far Outpost somewhere beneath Rockport. But I'm sure of the exact location. Yes, I believe it was hidden for some reason. If my information is correct, you'll need something called an Ultra Hammer to get it. Well, we picked up one of those like a couple seconds ago. Beat to the punch, boy. An Ultra Hammer? Don't act surprised, we just got it! I guess I sequence break right there. Well, it's party time then. We already got one of those. Oh, there we go. She corrected herself. Ah, well, I see. That certainly changes the subject now, doesn't it? Well, use that Ultra Hammer to find the pipe to Far Outpost, then. Get to it! You got it, Professor. Far Outpost, here we come. Oh, yes. One more thing you should be aware of. The Babombs who live there are sort of a Shirley bunch. They may not let you use their cannon. You may have to negotiate with them. In any case, that's your problem. Good luck. Get that last crystal star. I wonder what they want to negotiate for. Jeez. What do Babombs want? Exploding stuff? I have no idea. An exploding whoopee cushion, yes. That's obviously what they want. Okay, so right now we're just going to make our way to the west side of Roport, but first, let's see if this guy actually has some cool items. Slogo. Makes Mario run slow. Why the hell do you want that? Jumpman. Nothing really of importance. I don't know. I think I'm going to move on. I think I'm set in the badge department. But man, Slogo. I know he sells one that's Slogo, and he sells, like, double damage. There's a badge that he sells that does double damage to Mario. I don't know why you would ever equip that. I guess if you're trying to get a challenge, I have no idea. Oh, let's take out Yoshi. And let's go across. Nice, there we go. Smash! Man, Mario must have some strength to break a freaking stone block, jeez. Let's go in here. Alright, the last chapter we're trying to get a crystal star, which is Chapter 7. Yes, lucky number 7. Mario shoots the moon. This chapter's okay. The first half is a huge pain in the butt, but the second half's pretty cool. It has one of my favorite musics in the game, or pieces, I should say. Because music does not make a correctly grammarful sentence. Yeah. That didn't... Okay, yeah, that's why I didn't pass English. Well, I did, but whatever. Oh, wow, it's snow level. I was kind of expecting this. We haven't seen one the whole game. Whoa, seriously, it's so cold. Let's hurry up before we become popsicles. Far Outpost must be just ahead. Yeah, let's get a move on. Is there anything over here? Nothing. What about you? Oh, wow, that one's not even damageable. Jeez. Oh, I knew something was back here. There we go. Star piece. Yeah, I always have these intuitions. I don't think there's anything over here. I think that was only that one star piece. Oh, crap. New enemy. Might as well show it off. Let's see. It's like a rough puff, but this time it's blue. It's 9 HP each, wow. Ice Puffs. Let's show off Goombella's Rally Wink, actually. Might as well. And tap AB as they show. Okay. That was easy. And now we can attack twice in one turn. Awesome. Look at that damage. Holy crap! I didn't realize I could do that much damage. No wonder that Smorg was freaking so easy. Like, look at this. Just with power bounce, I want to know how much spring jump does. That probably does like 18. Oh, there we go. Nice, a bingo. That was kind of unnecessary, but it got our audience full, so I guess we'll take it. Just icing on the cake. Cake. Oh, what the hell are you trying to pull? It's like got a storm brewing right there. And let's use Gumbella to use multi-bonk. Oh, crap, you can't touch it? That's kind of indiscreet right there. Oh, there was a bone, honestly. Oh man, I'm kind of screwed right here. But I think we'll have to end it here because we're running out of time. So thank you guys for watching. Next time we'll hopefully make it a far, far outpost. See you later, guys.